Okay, it's rap packed to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got four cars and they all black. Got four bras and they all that. We call that ballin'. Doing this is my calling. Flow is so appalling. My phone off and she calling. I'm like, yeah, what it do? Penthouse, man, what a view. Fall back cause I'm coming through with my whole team. They coming too. That's real, too real. Motherfucker, tell me how you feel. I'm too good for my own good. I won't leak the album, I let it spill. Number one, bitch, I bet it will. Do the numbers, I said it will. I played the game and I'm still the same. And I never change just to get a deal. Bitch, I'm ballin', ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing. Yeah, you know I done it. Now there's no discussion, bitch, I'm ballin'.
I
made a promise to my mama. I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas. Bitch, I'm ballin', ballin'. Closing $1 million deals. Catch me swerving, burning $100 bills.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome to another fishing, one-of-a-kind fishing video, my bad. We got Andrew with me here today, and today we're going to be focusing on mangrove snapper fishing, mangrove fishing, anything we can really catch, so see you guys in the video.
All right, guys, so let's get my live shrimp here. This little dude, nice little snapper snag. Ah, shoot. So usually, guys, I like to hook them. No! God. Alright, guys, we're gonna hook him right through his, you know, mid body. Nice live shrimp. Let's go catch me some dinner. Yeah? You're on. Nice fish. I was a little schoolmaster, little guy. Actually, yeah, measure him up. Oh, I was. It's a nice little schoolmaster. I wonder if it's my hook. I'm using like a 2-out circle hook, and it's kind of been weird today, guys. Oh, shoot. Here, show the camera the fish. Nice little schoolmaster. Use your other pliers. Bro, come on. Use other pliers to get a better grip. Use the other pliers to get a better grip. Listen to me. You're not listening. Show the camera that fish. Let's see this nice little schoolmaster. Nice little guy. All right, toss him back. There he goes. There he goes, swimming off. All right. Let me catch a fish already. This is a new rod, actually, too. So I'm trying to break the skunk on the new rod, boys. You're on?
Yep.
Oh, nice. I think you got a little grunt. Oh, decent sized grunt. Look at that guy. Let me show the camera. That's a good little grunt. Nice. Yeah. Look at this grunt. Look at this guy. They put him in the box. He's a good one.
He's going in?
Yeah. Good little guy. Nice catch. I'm gonna have to change my shrimp up since they already got his legs off. Nice fish, bro. Andrew. Wow, you're gonna leave me hanging? Nice, good fish, bro. Andrew just caught a tiny little mangrove. Little guy. Little guy. Look at that little guy. It's more than I caught though, so I can't really say nothing. Alright. Alright guys. So little change of pace on location. Boy Andrew over there. The other spot really wasn't working out too much, guys. It was kind of crowded with some people. And the fish were just not biting today. It was weird. There's like a few fish. You guys saw us catch that grunt, but other than that, the fishing was kind of bad today there. So hopefully we can, you know, kind of chalk up the day here on the kayaks and see what we can do. But shout out to my uncle, guys, for letting us use his kayaks and then fish his area. So shout out to my uncle Mike. So as you can tell, guys, we have a nice like giant mangrove right here that we've actually been catching snapper on for like years and years now. So we're kind of gonna work our way out a little bit and see if we can see some, you know, bigger snapper. And you know, try to catch some dinner here, boys. You know, we got some live shrimp, so it should really come to our benefit, you know, kind of create some action in the mangroves, hopefully get these fish fired up. And we also have the chum bag too, to go ahead and get these fish going as well. So right now what we're doing, guys, is we're just kind of scouting these mangroves and kind of looking for any action we can see, so we're not blind fishing, you know, and hoping the fish will come. Like, what you want to do is you want to look for the fish or at least some really good structure to where the fish might be at. And then we start dropping baits and then, you know, kind of start to fish and hopefully catch. So last time we were here, guys, we were just kind of fishing like over in this area over here. And it starts to get deeper and the fish, like they were a million of them, guys. No joke, like a million of like mangroves over here. But the problem was they were just too small. Too small to keep, you know, they were a fun catch, but they were just way too small. So that kind of sucked. But that's why I have high hopes about this area. So I'm hoping that we'll see some mangroves, we'll see some bigger ones, or some grunts too, you know. Some grunts sound pretty tasty right now. All right, guys, so I just saw a massive, massive mangrove over there. I'm gonna try to catch him real quick. He looked to be by himself, so he should be pretty hungry. So we'll see what we can do. Just gonna cast Mr. Shrimp out there. Go catch me dinner, sir. Alright. Oh, there's mangroves here, boys. Alright, there's mangroves here, boys. It's a good sign. Just gotta pitch it a little deep in the mangroves. Just like that, they took my shrimp's head. The thing is, guys, it's so hard to fish these mangroves because especially without an anchor like I don't have right now, because it just wants to pull you away. Oh, I have a coot on it right now. No, I want a snapper. These mangs are hungry. Oh, I'm on. Oh, little guy though, little guy. Oh, look at this little guy. Beautiful fish, guys. Beautiful fish. Look at this guy right here. Nice little mang. Ate that big old live shrimp that we just put out there, guys. So it's a good sign. Good sign. That was actually my first fish on the new rod, too. All right. Thank you, buddy. We'll always love you. Oh, we're on. Oh, snap. Tiny little guy. Look at this. Look at this baby little mangrove. Look at this little guy. Feisty little guy. Bite my line when you're a 10 incher. You're on? Nice little guy. Oh, it's a grunt. That's a grunt. You foul hooked him though. Yeah, he is. Oh, no, he's not. Yeah. Nice little grunt. nice little grunt. Yeah, he's pretty small. Go ahead and throw him back. Alright guys, so we just found a nice little honey hole right there. Andrew actually just caught a nice little grunt too. And I just caught a snapper over there. So we're going to get another live shrimp. We're going to pitch it out. Sorry for not showing that to you guys. My GoPro's... the shrimp go? The shrimp just jumped out of the bucket at me. Sorry for not showing you guys, though. My GoPro's low on battery. Let's get back over to that dock area. Like I said, guys, you want to look for structure when mangrove fishing, and over there there's like a bait school of minnows, and there's like a bunch of like just mangrove snapper under these docks, guys. So you pitch your bait in the dark because the mangroves like the dark, and then especially the live shrimp, they're going crazy for it. So let's see if we can catch a good one. All right, come on, come on. It's so weird, guys. They're taking it, but then they're just like spitting it. It sucks. I just need to let them eat a little bit longer, I guess. There we go. There we go. Now we're on. There we go. Nice little mangrove snapper. There we go. Holy. What in the Nantucket? So this guy is not even close to 10 inches, guys. So what we're going to do is throw him back. You know, you don't want to, and you want to make it quick too. You don't want these guys out of the water because you want them to grow to be keepers one day. Man, these guys are a fun fish to catch. Look at them snapping at me. Whoa there, buddy. Thank you, Mr. Mangrove. Dude, he just pooped all on my hand. Look at this. Nasty. Guys, so we switched up the spot again. Really just looking for some big mangroves. As you guys can see, we're catching them. I just caught another one in there, so I'm gonna pitch my bait in here again and see if I can catch a bigger one. But we're getting some action, so it's always a good fishing day when we're getting some bites, getting some catching some fish, you know. So let's see if we can go ahead and just pitch this little shrimp in here real quick. Please, oh please, give me a fish. All right. Calling it. 3, 2. Oh. He just got whacked. Yo. We're on. Oh yeah. Little schoolmaster snapper, boys. What did I tell you? Little schoolmaster. So the size limit on these guys is the same as mangrove snapper, where they have to be 10 inches. And this guy's probably around like 5 or 6. So we're gonna let him go. But that was a quick bite. Later, bud. All right, live shrimp. Part 2, let's go. Catch me another fish. That was a terrible cast. I have no idea what that was. All right, catch me a fish. Come on, shrimp. Come on. I believe. He's already getting whacked. I see him. Come on, fish. You see the line, guys? He's taking it. Fish on. Oh, nice little mang. Look at this guy, guys. Nice little mangrove. Still not 10 inches, but boy, oh boy, are they fun to catch. He said he's 15. All right, reel him in. Thanks, little mangrove. All right, guys, so welcome back. After a long day of fishing, we're finally at the fillet table. Not much to prove for it, but we got three little grunts. You know, we'll make sandwiches out of them. You know, they're gonna be tiny little fillets, but you know, we'll do our best. So I'm gonna show you guys how to clean them, especially cleaning smaller fish. It's a little bit difficult for beginners. I'm still a beginner, I'm still learning. So let's go ahead and get to a fish. So we'll get to these little fish right here. And guys, I'm actually wearing a glove in this video, so for one, I don't cut myself. This is like a rubber glove, so if I accidentally miss, I won't hit myself. And also, it's easier to get a grip on the fish. And you won't poke yourself, and it makes things a little bit faster. So as per usual, guys, above the fin. Cut right through. Follow right down along that spine. Smaller fish, guys, are so much harder to fillet.
Oh, you're coming out the bottom there.
Yeah. Cut under his stomach. You guys already know, cut down, there's the spine. Smaller fish are extremely hard to fillet. That's why a lot of people don't like small fish. But as you guys can see, if you take your time with it, work your way down the backbone, and you cut along the spine, I didn't really do the best job here by the head, but if you cut down the spine, you can get these nice little nugget-sized fillets and, you know, cut out the rib cage and stuff like that. And yeah, we're gonna have some grunt sandwiches. So catch you guys back in the kitchen for the... All right, guys, welcome back. We're in the kitchen. We got all washed up. So we got some grunt snapper fillets. As you can tell, and by the fillet table, we really didn't get much, but we got enough. So here's the plan that we're gonna do. We're gonna do some grunt sliders. So we got our Hawaiian rolls right here. And all we're gonna do is pan sear this grunt and then, you know, kind of put a little bit on each slider and it'll get the most value out of the tiny little fillets that we got. So if you follow us over here, we're gonna wash these little fillets off. Usually it's not really good to do it with fresh water because it is a saltwater fish and you don't want to ruin the texture and the quality of the meat. But if you're about to cook them, then you can, you know, run them under the water real quick and then put them in there. So let's go ahead and go do that. Nice little grunt. So this was three grunts here, guys. It's crazy. All right, so now let's pan sear them. All right, guys, so as you can tell, we're just gonna pan sear them real quick. Don't really wanna keep them on too hot of a heat, and then you also just wanna keep them on for like a minute and a half each side, and then yeah, pretty much good to go. So looking really, really nice. All right, so now we got our grunt pan seared. Look at how much is actually in the pan. Not very much. So that's exactly why we're doing grunt sliders. So if you come over here, this is the plan. So we got these little Hawaiian rolls right here. So we're just gonna open them up like this. We got some pieces of cheese. Drop a little piece of cheese on there.
Now this is a little experiment. I've actually never had bacon with fish. If I'd imagine on a grunt slider, it would, you know, kind of fill the sandwich and accommodate for the lack of food. So we'll put a little piece of bacon on there. Put a little piece of grunt. Boom. Look at this, a grunt slider. Let's get a little closer with that. Grunt slider is perfect. All right, so here's for the taste test. Take a slider, take a slider. Not bad. Once.
Great, go.
All right, let me see this real quick. Take a slider. Pretty good stuff, huh? Let me get one. Let's try these out. That's pretty good. Wow. Bacon with the cheese with the grunt. That was amazing.
It was.
That is lights out. Not bad for catching small little fish with small little fillets. Do little sliders, it makes it go a long way. Like, comment, subscribe for more.